Hi, welcome to SOLIDWORKS 2017 video tutorial. I want to do the advanced rim in SOLIDWORKS. So, let's have fun with SOLIDWORKS. So, in order to save time, I want to reuse this sketch, which is from my simple rim. So you can do it with the same dimensions or different, doesn't really matter, it's just an exercise. So let's close that sketch, and I did already a surface revolve around the axis, which I also defined in my simple rim. Let's hide this one. And I need two planes, so let's show that one and maybe show those planes. It's okay. I need two planes, so go for plane. I want to use this as axis and as reference. Don't go for coincident, go for an angle, and that angle should be 15 degrees. Then I'll need another one. Again, rotate it around this axis, and reference is again this one. And again, I go for an angle of 15 degree, but I will flip the normal. Oh no, not flip the normal, but flip the offset and confirm. Now up to some sketches, let's hide those planes. Okay. And a sketch on the first plane on this one. And maybe I can show that one just as reference. I need an arc. This and add a line for tangency. Those two should be tangent. Let's see. Let's move this a little bit down. Maybe like that. And close that sketch. I need a plane normal to that curve in this point. So go for a plane. In this normal to that curve. And then a sketch on this one. And I could hide this feature for the moment. Another arc. This point should be coincident to the midpoint, and those two points should be aligned. Okay. And maybe this goes like that. So let's go for the next sketch. I will do the sweep afterwards. So right now I'm on this plane, so I have to go for that plane. I need on this plane a sketch. Again an arc. A line for the tangency. Those two should be tangent. And this should be vertical or horizontal aligned. Yep. Let's show the revolve. Yeah, that's okay. And move it down. Maybe like this, okay? And no, let's make this a little bit shorter. Like that, and move this a little bit over here, maybe like this. Looks okay. Then go for another plane in that point, normal to that curve. So another plane through this point and normal to that curve and confirm. Now let's hide that one and do a sketch on the plane 4. And maybe hide those for the moment. Okay, this will be another arc. Okay, this point should be on that curve as midpoint, and those two points should be aligned. No, horizontal and confirm. And again, make this a little bit bigger. Now let's do the sweeps. Swept surface. That's this profile, and that would be the curve. Confirm. Same here. Sketch profile and curve. And confirm. I've just realized those planes with 15 degrees should be at 7.5 degree, I suppose. So let's change those. this, not the sketch, but the plane should be at 7.5. And the other plane as well. Not a sketch, but the plane. Again, 7.5. Confirm. Now I need a sketch on the top plane. I might show this one. And one on the top plane. And this could be something like this. Okay. And that angle should be 30. And this should be 15. Now let's see if we can trim. Surface trim, that's the trim tool, and I want to remove this one and that one. Confirm. And I just noticed that's the wrong one. Let's go back. I don't want to remove this, I want to remove that side. And okay. And then I want to use the this as trim tool. So go for another trim. That's the tool, and I want to remove this side and that side. Yeah. That's okay. Then I could trim those two with the hidden revolve. So bring this back, and I can trim once more with this surface, that away, and this away. And confirm. To trim even more, I need a circle right here on the top plane. So go for top plane sketch. And that would be a circle. Diameter maybe 100. Then trim once more, surface trim. That's the trim tool, the sketch, yes, and I want to remove those two small ends. Great. I need an extrude and a sketch on the front plane, so I go for the sketch on the front plane. And that's something like this. That should be, of course, an arc. So go for arc here, maybe like this. Okay. Make those two tangent. Move this a little bit over here. like this. And okay, leave that sketch. And then I will need one on the top plane again. Another sketch. This would be just a line. Maybe like that. Make an extrude. Confirm. And let's draw this a little bit over here so I can trim that surface with this line, and I might need another one, so I could go for that sketch and add just a horizontal line, maybe like this. Let's see if we can trim, if it extends these. So go for a surface trim. And that would be the tool. I want to remove this side and that side. Confirm. And another trim. So one sketch is hidden. This one. Let's see if we can trim that one with this one. Surface trim. I want to use this circle. And I want to remove that side. Okay. Repeat that command. And that's the tool. Tool. And I want to remove this side. Okay. Let's hide the revolve and do the thickening. Now let's thicken those surfaces. So go for thicken. Let's start with this one. It should go 5 millimeter to one side and to the upper one. Okay, confirm. Next thicken without merging the result is this one. Okay, and another one. And this could be symmetrical. Don't merge. And confirm. Okay, I forgot the sketches, so we'll go up here, back to my surfaces, and I need another sketch on the top plane. And I could hide those. No, I don't want to hide those. So we'll need a circle, maybe here, but I could show those two planes, this one and that one, and the center point should be on that plane. Okay. Maybe a little bit smaller. That's too small, so go for a dimension and make it 10, for example, yeah, or even 15, yeah. let's move this up a little bit, maybe like that. Okay, then I need some lines. This one and that one should be parallel. This one and that one should be parallel as well. And there should be an angle, and that angle should be, of course, 30. No, 15. And 15. I think that will be a very small one, because one, it's only 15, and I think 3 times it should be 60. So let's change this. So let's take a look. That's 30 degrees, and I would need 12 of those, so I want only to use 6 of those. So I should change, of course, that sketch, I suppose. Yes, this one. Let's go back, change that sketch. No, this sketch. That's 30, it should be 60 and 30. Let's take a look. Yeah, this should be 30, and this should be 60. Let's see. No, that's too big. So let's undo this. Or because that would be right now would be 15 and 15. Yeah, that's okay. Let's change those planes to 15 and 2nd one as well to 15, and confirm and update this. Okay, let's take a look at trim. That's an extrude. This one. So that surface trim should be I want to remove this face and that face. Confirm. Yeah, that's more like it. Okay, now let's edit this one. Okay, so this point should be on that plane, coincident, and this point should be on this plane, coincident. Those two angles should be 30, 30, and this could then be, let's say, 20 or even 25. Yeah. Now let's use a fillet, maybe 20 right here. And another one, maybe 10 over here. So let's move this point a little bit, maybe like that, yeah. And move this as well, maybe like this. And I could add some dimensions. This could be 15, and that could be 15 as well. Okay, looks good. Now let's move that circle a little bit, if possible, maybe like that. Okay, now let's trim once more. The trim tool would be that sketch. I want to remove this face, that face, and this one. Confirm. And this looks good. Now let's go for the thickening and see if the thickening could update. Yes. Okay, so let's do the shells. Yeah. Shell 2 millimeter, yes. This face should be removed. This one, that one, this one, that one, and of course this one, but that will be inside that one, so it doesn't matter. Great. Another shell over here. This should be removed. That one, this one, this one, and that one. And again, I can leave this one on the side, doesn't matter. Maybe that circle should be a little bit smaller. And that would be which sketch? That sketch. So let's go for let's do 20. Okay, now I want to mirror that one, but before I do mirror it, I want to use fillets. Fillet, let's go for 5 millimeter. On this edge, that edge, this one, and that one. Confirm. Now mirror the body. This body should be mirrored. So go for mirror. Body, that body here. And with this plane, confirm, and again with the other one, mirror, again, body, and the mirror plane would be the second one. combine those bodies. I could have done the edge fillet before, here and there, or afterwards. Yeah, doesn't matter. So go for combine, combine this body, that one, this one, that one, and this one. Let's do fillets. First 1 millimeter on this edge, that one, this one, and that one. Confirm. Go over to that side. And again, 1 millimeter fillets, edge, 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 and here as well, fillet, edge, 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 and this edge, confirm. Now let's go for 2 millimeter. This one, that one, this one, that one. Confirm. Now the underside. This could be 5, so fillet, let's try 5 on this edge, that edge, this one, that one. Confirm. Great. Now I will need a circular pattern, and we will see if we can combine those. So go for a circular pattern. I want to pattern a body, this body, and the axis would be this axis, 6 or with 360 degrees, and confirm. So I got 6 bodies. We will see if we can combine those, because sometimes you will get 0 thickness errors. Let's go for combine. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, of course, 0 thickness. So where do we get a 0 thickness here? So I can't combine those patterns instances, so I will delete the pattern, and I might have to delete some fillets, because I think the fillets cause the problems, the fillets on right here, because if you have that fillet and that wall, it would create 0 thickness. So one way would be to delete one of those bodies or delete those fillets. Maybe these as well. So could these work? It comes from that side. That's a really awkward problem with those Parzolit-based programs. So I will delete the fillets right here and see if I can pattern this one and combine it. So let's go for a circular pattern. I want to pattern those bodies. Okay, and the axis would be this one. Confirm. Let's see if we can combine those. Combine. Confirm. Yeah. So we'll have to do the fillets down here. Okay, let's go for fillet. 5 would be okay. And select this one and that one. Maybe I can. Yeah, maybe I can pattern that feature, the fillets. Let's see. Oh, that's really awkward. Okay, can I pattern those fillets? Would be great. So let's try go for a circular pattern. In this case it's a feature pattern. The axis would be the same as before. And I want to pattern the feature. That last fillet, this one. Preview looks okay. Let's see if it works. Of course it doesn't. So I will have to do them one by one. So this one. This one, come on, that's very slow with fillets. Really strange behavior. So I've got face. Let's confirm this and go for a different view style. This might help. Okay. Go. I will split it in more than one. So that's one edge. Again, I got a face. G. This edge, no, again I got the face. Could I select just edges? Filter faces, filter surface, bodies, solid bodies, axis. Planes is the sort of edge, there is edge. Okay, this edge. This one. That one. Now again, face, this one, that's really, really awkward. Very slow with those fillets. last one and confirm. Okay, at least I got this one. Don't forget to switch off that filter. Now I want to use thicken. I could hide this body. Let's hide it and show our surface revolve and thicken it. Go to thicken. Maybe 4 or 5 to the inside, or make it 3 in both directions or 4 in both directions. Okay, and add some fillets. Fillet 5. No, not the face, just the edge, and maybe that edge as well. Okay, show this body and combine them, combine this one and that one. Great. Let's see if we can do some more fillets here. If not, I will leave that changes up to you. So let's try a fillet, maybe 2 millimeter, and see if we can go all around. Would be great. Yes. So let's see if it works. Yeah. Maybe add some more to that feature. Come on. Maybe let's do 6 and 6. Confirm. And do another 6 with a second fillet. That's very, very slow. Okay, confirm. Now I need another sketch on the top plane. So where's my top plane? There you go. Make a sketch. This should be another circle, and diameter might be 160. Oh, that's too big, so go for 140. Even 130. Yeah, that's okay. Leave that sketch and make an extrude. with that sketch. And make this, let's take a look, to 6.5 to, let's say 270, and make it a new body, so don't merge the result. Let's go for a camphor right there. This edge and make it distance asymmetric. Let's go for, I think the first one, yeah, let's go for 15. The other way around, so this might be 10 and that might be 50 or 40 or even 30. Yeah, looks okay. Now give it a fillet on that edge, maybe 5. Then combine this one and that one. Let's try to fillet this. Go for fillet on that edge. Preview works, so let's confirm. Okay. Yeah, then maybe a hole here, so go for a hole wizard and diameter might be, yeah, 30 40. Let's go for 40 and see if it works. Depth up to next. Yes, go for precision, select the face and then the center right here, and yeah, this could be probably 50. Confirm. And I think I'm done. So I hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Yeah, you could do the fillets here as well. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook Cat Fan page. I want to get more subscriptions and likes over there as well. So let's try that last fillet here. Confirm. Thanks for watching. See you to next one. Bye bye.